Hello, this is Anand Rao, a field technologist at VMware's Tanzu division. Today, we're going to talk about how we can operationalize Kubernetes and make it more efficient for developers, SecOps, and AppOps using the DevSecOps workflow. To begin with, we always have developers and designers sitting together and coming up with ideas and designs for the application or a change for an application that's already in place. And then a common set of needs that are put on top of these developers and designers are the application has to be secure, consistent, fast, and scalable, and all of that, right? With all of that in mind, when the developer starts to build their applications and the designers are helping them in the designs, they have to reach the user who's at the other end of the spectrum as quickly as possible. And in the current day world where we are trying to deploy all of these applications into Kubernetes as containerized workloads, we are going to find a lot of things that we need to take care of. You know, I almost call it pit stops in a journey that we're going to take today and see how we are having the needs for each of these processes. And then we talk about how Tanzu can help you in those steps. Okay? Starting with that, as a developer, what do I need? As a developer, I need a development environment with the tools, the IDE, the connectivity to a test environment, and everything that I need to follow through what we call the inner loop or a developer loop that runs multiple times a day. A developer is writing code, making the changes, sending it to an automated testing tool, get the feedback, and then process the next step. The first pit stop we need to take in our journey is a development environment, right? What is it that the developers need to make sure that they're able to efficiently develop the application, right? As part of this, they might need tools, they might need IDEs, they might need libraries, they might need a deployment environment to test their development efforts. All of that has to be provided and make sure that the tools and the environments we provide are secure, consistent, and reproducible. And as part of that, Tanzu has a few things that we offer. One of the key things that we talk about when we are talking about development environments is the Spring ecosystem. Tanzu's the flag bearer for the entire Spring ecosystem, where we bring the best of breed and the most used Java framework as part of the Tanzu Spring ecosystem. And then one of the things that we did was we saw that the goodness that Spring brings to the developer community were missing on the .NET side of the world. So what we did was created the steel toe library set, which we donated to the .NET Foundation ever since. And as a combination, we bring a lot of the goodness from the Spring world into the .NET side of the world as well. So once we talk about completing the development efforts, now that we have given the tools and the IDEs to the developers, they finish their development, and then we go to the next phase of our journey where I'm going to run a bunch of unit tests, and then I'm going to run my integration tests, and I am ready to package my application. So when we're talking about packaging my application for Kubernetes, you know, with the target of Kubernetes being the deployment environment, what we need is a secure, reproducible build that can also be checked for security vulnerabilities constantly and also have an easy way to patch those vulnerabilities, right? So we need a good packaging system. And Tanzu brings the best of the breed in Tanzu Build Service. Tanzu Build Service is actually based on the foundational component called the Cloud Native Build Packs, which is an open source project under the CNCF foundations. Tanzu Build Service brings the scaffolding needed to make sure that you're constantly looking for changes in your source code and then automatically build the image based on that, right? And it doesn't limit you to the changes in the source code. It also constantly checks for making sure that if you have any updates to the base image, any updates to the build packs themselves, all of these changes are tracked by build service, and build service also knows all the images that are using each of those components, and it'll automatically rebuild your images and store them in a registry of your choice. So when we talk about a container registry, what we have here is a need for enterprise-grade storage of your container images. What does it mean by enterprise-grade storage? We talk about the needs of constant checking for vulnerabilities in the images, constant checking on who is pulling those images, having audit trails of all the images coming through, and then having an consistent way to pull those images into your clusters, right? That is where Tanzu supports this open source project called Harbor in a big way. We are VMware and Tanzu, we are the biggest contributors to Harbor, and then Harbor is supported fully by VMware, and we bring it to you as an enterprise-grade registry. So now that we have developed our applications and stored a packaged image in our registry, what else do we have as a need, right? You know, we have not seen any single application which does not need a database or a messaging system these days. So you're always building cloud-native applications, right? So to build a true cloud-native application that's usable for the user, you will normally have a need to bring in either an open source service like a database, MySQL, Postgres, RabbitMQ, Kafka, whatever else, right? Or you might even need third-party applications that might be needed for your application to function correctly. So a common problem when you're bringing third-party applications and you're bringing open source applications is, how can you guarantee the security of those things? How can you guarantee that there's no vulnerabilities on those images that you bring into the system? And that's where you need a catalog or a marketplace of applications that is vetted and curated by a team or a security team or a compliance team in your system, right? So as part of that, you need a way to consistently build those images for those open source applications, for those third-party applications, and have that available in your catalog. And this is where Tanzu brings all of the technology that was in the Bitnami portfolio of applications, if you will, wherein we allow you to overlay those application bits on top of a secure, hardened image, potentially provided by your compliance or your security team, and then have that available in the registry of your choice, right? So we're talking about hardened and secure. So the catalog is going to provide you all of these marketplace items available for the user, for your application, in the same registry. So now that we have a custom-developed application in the registry and all of the services that we need in the registry, it's time to deploy the application. So that's where you're going to have a continuous deployment tool running potentially a continuous deployment pipeline, which will deploy this into a Kubernetes cluster. So now we talk about how we're going to manage these applications that are running on the Kubernetes cluster, right? So once again, when we talk about deployment into a Kubernetes cluster, what is the type of Kubernetes cluster you're expecting? You want to make sure it is upstream compliant dial tone. It is consistent with all of the other dial tones that we have with Kubernetes. So the best way to do that is making sure your dial tone for Kubernetes is going to be upstream compliant. And then when we talk about upstream compliant, it could be Tanzu's TKG, which we think very strongly about, and we are very proud about the fact that it's one of the best Kubernetes offerings in the market. But it could also be any other Kubernetes offering. It could be from your cloud provider or otherwise, right? Now that we've deployed our application into a Kubernetes cluster, what are the next things that we need to worry about when we're talking about operationalizing Kubernetes, right? The first thing that we need to talk about is management. I need to manage my applications that are running on the clusters. I also need to manage my clusters themselves. So that is the most important next step that we need to worry about and talk about when we talk about the whole workflow here, right? So we have two different personas and two different perspectives, as I talked about. One is an application operator, and another persona that we need to talk about is a cluster operator. Both have different views of managing pieces of the puzzle in this cluster. So as part of the management, one of the things that I always talk about is pets versus cattle, right? Previously, you used to have one or two or three clusters that were big in size, and then you were able to care and feed for those clusters as if they were pets. But then now that we are going into a scenario or a world where we have potentially hundreds or thousands of clusters, how do you manage those high scale, how do you manage those clusters at scale? And then how do you make sure that you're managing those clusters at scale with efficiency as well, right? For that, you need to be able to manage those clusters with a single set or a small set of policies such that those policies drive the management of the clusters. So Tanzu brings a big advantage or a big tooling around it. We call it TMC, Tanzu Mission Control. Tanzu Mission Control allows you to have policy-based management of the clusters as a group of clusters. So we have these constructs like cluster groups that allows cluster operators to manage, you know, 10, 100, or you know, multiple hundreds of clusters with the same set of policies or a small set of policies. The policies can drive all the way from user control and registry management, network, security policies, and all of that. And it also goes to allow you custom policies using OPA, using its Rego language there. And then similarly, for the application operator, an application operator scenario is that the application might be actually deployed into multiple namespaces within the same cluster. It could also be deployed into multiple namespaces that are spread across multiple clusters. And those clusters are not guaranteed to be in the same geography or even the same cloud provider. So what happens when your namespaces are spread across multiple different geographies and clusters? An application operator wants to look at all of them as single, with a single lens, if you will, right? That's why Tanzu Mission Control brings this concept, a virtual construct called Workspaces. Workspaces is a collection of namespaces, which allows the operator to start looking at all the namespaces where his or her application is running as a single set of namespaces that they can manage with a single set of policies, right? So that's what TMC brings to the table. Okay, now we talked about management. What else is there in managing or operationalizing a cluster? Observability. What happens when something goes wrong, right? You know, you need to make sure that the pieces that are going wrong are brought back to normalcy or operational state as soon as possible. You need to have reduced MTTR, right? You know, mean time to resolution of the problems. And that's where you will need a cloud-native observability tool here. So when we talk about cloud-native observability, what do we mean by cloud-native observability? We need to make sure that the modern constructs that supports like the SRE needs, right? You know, the SRE needs, which include SLAs and SLOs, and making sure all of the EE, like pieces of information, all the way from an application which might be running in a container, which might be running in a pod, which might be running on a VM, which might be running on a hardware, right? So you need to have full stack observability and also make sure that's cloud native. So that's where you need a powerful observability tool that allows you to start looking at this entire ecosystem in a full picture. And that's where Tanzu brings Tanzu Observability. Tanzu Observability is a product which is built from the ground up as a cloud native full stack observability tool. Now that we have covered our management piece, our observability piece, another key piece that's missing is we talked about clusters and spreading across multiple clusters. So let's What happens when we really start looking at them as multiple clusters, right? Gone are those, as I mentioned to you, gone are those days when you had a single cluster working through that. You might already have multiple clusters where you're spreading your application for multiple different reasons into these clusters. How does the user start to visualize all of this together? Where do you merge them? How do you have your pieces of your application connect to the other pieces which are running on other clusters? That's where Tanzu brings another piece of the puzzle called Tanzu Service Mesh, which is right now implemented using Istio, but then we are trying to expand that to include a lot of other features, which might include things like how do you work with legacy systems, VMs, and all of that, and how do you mesh those networks together, right? But the key aspect of Tanzu Service Mesh is that it makes the applications liberated in the sense that they don't have to worry about identifying where the other pieces of the applications are. Tanzu Service Mesh brings this concept of global namespace, which allows the applications to start connecting into those other application pieces irrespective of where they are running. It could be on the same cluster, it could be on different clusters, and it allows for automatic encryption and then the security of the data, the pipe of the data that's going across different clusters. Once we have the service mesh implemented and in place, that's when your user can now start visualizing, utilizing all of the cool features that the developers built on this side, and you've taken your journey through the whole system, and then you potentially have a happy user. So that's where we are talking about using a DevSecOps flow, where we have a, you know, focus on developer needs, focus on security needs every step of the way, focus on operational needs every step of the way to build out a platform that's automated in a way that you can expand your horizon, expand your scalability of your application across the board and have a happy user at the other end. And this is where we call this flow as almost like a DevSecOps flow, which makes sure that you're operationalizing your Kubernetes cluster to make sure your applications are efficiently running on those clusters. Thank you very much for listening.